States is by far the single largest contributor to the United Nations and its agencies.
But now it may change after Nikki Haley said on Christmas Eve that the U.S. had negotiated a $250 million cut to the U.N.'s annual budget. Her announcement echoed President Donald Trump's threat to cut funding to countries who voted against the U.S. proposal to recognize Jerusalem as Israel's capital at the U.N. General Assembly.
For all of these nations that take our money and then they vote against us at the Security Council, or they vote against us potentially at the Assembly, they take hundreds of millions of dollars and even billions of dollars and then they vote against us. Well, we're watching those votes. Let them vote against us. We'll save a lot. We don't care.
On December 18th, 14 out of 15 members of the UN Security Council voted in favor of the resolution to rescind the U.S. decision. The U.S. exercised its veto power. Then a few days later, on the 21st, the U.S. faced more opposition at the UN General Assembly. 128 of 172 countries, including U.S. allies Britain, Germany, France, Italy, and Japan, voted in favor of a proposal affirming international opposition to recognizing Jerusalem as Israel's capital. Only 7 countries, including Guatemala, Honduras, and the Marshall Islands, voted against.
The United States will remember this day in which it was singled out for attack in the General Assembly for the very act of exercising our right as a sovereign nation. We will remember it when we are called upon to once again make the world's largest contribution to the United Nations. And we will remember it when so many countries come calling on us, as they so often do, to pay even more and to use our influence for their benefit.
This is not the first time Washington has cut its UN contribution, mainly used in peacekeeping, oversight and management matters, and reform initiatives. According to Reuters, the U.S. has delayed nearly $900 million of payment between 2016 and 2017, and Washington has indicated that there are strings attached.
When we make generous contributions to the UN, we also have a legitimate expectation that our goodwill is recognized and respected.
The U.S. has said the country is too generous to the United Nations, and Sunday's announcement on further reductions reflects the American First policy of Donald Trump. Zhao Yunfei, CGTN.